second up here. We're the next contestant on the Who Want That Game Show.
Where do you want me to stand?
And you are going to stand over here.
Is there your foot?
Yes. Don't step on my foot. That'd be a whole different story.
Right,
okay.
Jonathan Purdy.
Okay. I have these giant cards here.
What's that?
Okay. Any card. Don't make too much cards. I think any card. Alright.
What's
any
that?
Card.
That's code to get you out?
Got you. Any card.
Okay. You go get some more rest.
You're going to do is this. I'm going to guess the value or the suit or color of the card. Now, if I get it correct, you get a prize. If I don't get it correct, you still get a prize. Okay, so this is good. Okay. Okay, I'm going to start with JD Swiss, no offense. Okay, kidding. I'm guessing this. I'm guessing. I'm guessing Kaden, yours is a red card, right? Flip over. Wow. Okay. Yours is a black card, right?
Wow.
And I did not look at the cards beforehand. They're saying no. Alright, let's see what do I Alright. Yours is a red card, right? Yeah, I know. Yours is a red card, right?
Mine. No.
So yours is a black, right?
Yes.
Well, even though I got it wrong, you guys still get a prize. So, Kaden, I have something special for you. It's like a finger thing. I guess you want a special drawing thing. Okay. Alright, who wants the shrine? Anyone? Okay, we'll take the card. We'll probably eat you up. Okay, it won't eat you. It'll probably devour you. Okay, what else do I have? Oh! Who wants these edible racers?
What?
Brendan, okay.
What
oh, you're probably next.
Edible what?
Erasers.
Ooh.
And you have the special inspirational stickers.
Oh, that's nice.
And now, guys, you can take them. Okay, you guys can sit down. And now, who is ready for the next part? No one is because you guys think I'm kidding. Okay, we are going to do a new game. A friend of mine, Tom Bajo, he reviewed this on his channel. This game is called Pancake Pile Up. Let me actually put this down. Okay, so what you guys are going to do is it's going to be two teams. Red team blue. They're going to take this pancake on this spatula, okay? You can have your hand over it, then put it on the plate. So you have to have all five pancakes piled up on top of each other. And then the last part is put the butter on top. Huh? Now there's a catch. The catch is, if at any point the pancakes that you trickle one time to the plate from your side of the table, you have to have the same pancake on the spatula again, start over, so you have it piled up. Now, if the pancakes that are piled up fall down, you have to start over again.
Oh, no.
And then you have all five pancakes, including the butter, piled up. You got it? All right, just a practice round. I'm going to be Tim. I am a guy.
Oh!
That's supposed to be a joke. Okay. Alright. So, you do this. Okay. Then, the next person takes the next pancake.
Don't drink
it. You can use this right here to fix it up. That's what I know. Then, next person takes the banana.
Oh!
I'm sorry. You guys got it? You guys got it? Alright, I think we show you guys my phone. Alright.
Enjoying yourselves.
You are going to be on team two.
Marilyn,
yes,
wait.
There
you go.
Team two, team two.
Wait, by the way, we're going to have Salty on in a few minutes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yes. It doesn't matter. You can use your hand to get up. Alright, are you guys ready? Alright. Oh, we can't let go. Yeah, I guess it's all her fault. John, I think my
wife. Yo, John, we have to pause. 1 minute. Give me the mic. Okay. Hello, everybody. Sorry that this started so late. That was the fault of the Holy Spirit through a very anointed speaker. It was not my fault. And he went long and long, and it was wonderful. And anybody, by the way, who's here who missed the service, you can see it online at the Upper Room Facebook page. But let me just do a quick word over the food. It's something you've been eating already. Pray over the food. You just, as we're doing everything, just come and grab the food. And we've got Pastor Clef's chili.
Yeah.
We have two prize-winning egg salads from Jan and Mona. I mean, two. We have Israeli eggs out. We have other kind of snacks, and we'll have cake in a little bit. So let me pray. God, we just thank you. John, where are you? We thank you. Thank you for my son, Jonathan. Thank you for this day. Thank you. We can all gather together here, Lord, and you protect everybody here from any infection and any disease. And we worship you, and I ask you to bless our special speaker that we're going to have shortly. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3, banana. Banana, I say banana. Banana, I say the pancake banana. Go. Pancake banana. It's this batch and take the pancake banana to the plate. Yes. I say go, pancake banana. That's team one, this is team two plate. Okay. Alright, next question. Get the brain pancake. Go. You can use your hand if you want to. Okay, next one. Blueberry, go. It's a mother versus a mother. Who will win? A mother or a monkey?
This is strawberries.
Alright, chocolate chip. Go. Alright. That's my name. It's strawberry. Alright, strawberry, go. Go. Strawberry. Then after that, so I have to put the butter on top.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh. It's okay. You can't put it back on top. That's fine. All right, go back. What? Oh, the butter. Who's going to put the butter on top? Someone needs to put the butter.
Butter.
Go. Like a crow.
Oh.
Hey, you have 13 to win. But I have a prize for all you guys, so I have to open here.
Alright,
who wants
chase
from
Paw
Patrol?
Who
wants
chase?
From
Paw
Patrol?
No,
Paw Patrol would be the only one.
Okay.
Yeah. Who wants
some?
It
is?
A
bacon.
I
do
like
Paw
Patrol.
Except
the
chips.
Who wants
some?
Candy
corn.
Corn.
Excel.
We are going
to do some songs. So I need everyone to stand up. Stand up.
Stand up. Oh, it's the demon.
Yeah, stand up. I say stand up. Yo, we're doing song to you. Yeah, I say stand up. If you guys are in this case. Alright, this is going to go throw them back, okay? Alright, let me put this down. Alright. I'm in right, up, right, down, right, up, right, happy all the time. I'm in right, up, right, down, right, in my happy all the time. I sing Jesus Christ gave me and praise my heart for sin. I am I upright now, right, upright, happy all the time. Alright, who wants me to go faster? Okay, someone wants me to go faster, okay. I am I upright now, right, happy all the time. I am I upright now, right, happy all the time. I said, Jesus Christ, you didn't curse my heart. Say, I am I upright now, right, happy all the time. Alright, now, slow motion.
Going on. So let me ask you a specific question. What's going on? Okay. Here's what I think. I don't know.
What? You what?
I don't know what's going on.
Okay. Well, all right. Thank you for sharing that. Do you have any specific answers to what can be done about what's going on in the world?
I don't know.
Okay. You don't know? What do you know?
I don't know.
Is that good?
No.
Do you run away from people who need help? Don't answer that. No, of course not. So if Duncan runs away, we're going to teach him this scripture. He says, I think we're ready to call him now. Go ahead and call Duncan. Duncan. It didn't work.
Try it again.
Duncan. Wait a second. We did spend a lot of time at McDonald's. He drank three of those extra large Coca-Colas. So he's probably back there. Let's turn around and call Duncan. Duncan! Is he over there? Is he in the bathroom? Is he there? Can you see him? He what? Okay, kids, he must still be in the bathroom. Let's call him again. Where are you? There you are! Aha!
Aha!
What are you looking at?
Your face.
Why?
Is it a booger?
This little black thing under my nose is not. Some microphones so people can hear me sing.
I don't need your mission.
Gow! You fooled me. That was not singing, that was screaming.
Try it again. Gow!
Why don't you sing them your good song? You want to hear his good song, everybody? Okay. Why don't you sing your goods? I know. If you clap real loud, he'll sing for you. Clap for him. Why do you have the sad face?
It's a sad song.
You still want to hear it even if he's sad? Okay, go ahead. Sing him your sad song. You wrote it.
Seen $1 million. That's what I mean. You look like something I ain't never seen before. Okay, Jay. Well, I tell you what. What's that? Tonight we came out here to tell a Bible story. Hey, you know what I want? You want? So you want something? Yeah, you know what I want? What do you want? I want a skunk. Jay, you cannot have a skunk. Why not? Or are you going to keep him?
In Pastor Chris's office.
You're going to keep your skunk in Pastor Chris's office?
That's right.
Jay, what about the smell?
Oh, the skunk will get used to it.
Jay, I tell you what, we didn't come up here to talk about skunks or gifts. Hey, you know what I got for you? You got me something? I sure did. All right, well, tell me, what is it? No, I want to show you. You going to show me? I do, okay? Well, what do you want me to do? Close your eyes, okay? My eyes are closed. Are they closed real tight? They're closed real tight. Now, what do you see? Nothing. Oh, that's what you're getting. All right. Well, Jay, anyway, we came up here to tell a Bible story, okay? Okay. This story happened a long time ago when God's people lived in a land called Judah. Huda. They lived in Judah. Huda. They lived in Judah. Judo. Hiya. Okay. They didn't live in Judo. They lived in Judah. That's where God's people lived. And one day, people from the land of Babylon, where? Babylon. Where? Babylon. Where? Babylon. Where? Babylon. You sure do. What, Babylon?
That's right.
Okay, people from the land of Babylon, they came and they surrounded all of God's people in the land of Judah. Judah! Hey! And they took prisoners back to Babylon. Where? Never mind. Now, in Babylon, there was a king. And the king's name was King Nebuchadnezzar. Excuse you. What for? You sneezed. No, Jay, I did not sneeze. Yes, you did. I heard you. You said the king's name was King Nebuchadnezzar. No, Jay. Nebuchadnezzar. Was he a snotty dude? No, Jay. He was the king. So anytime I say king and I do my hand like this, I want y'all to say Nebuchadnezzar. Here we go. King Nebuchadnezzar. Anyway, king, he ruled over the land of Babylon and he took all these prisoners from the land of Judah. Judah! Hey! Now, among these prisoners were three young men whose names were Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Not Shadrach, your Shadrach, or Abednego?
No, Jay. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Now, here's where y'all need to help me. Anytime I point over here, I want you guys to all say Shadrach. These two sections here say Shadrach. Okay, you got to be loud with it. Here we go. Now, when I point over here, I want these two sections to say Meshach. And when I point right in the middle, I want everybody to say Abednego. Okay, ready? Here we go. All right, now let's try that. The three young men, their names were? And?
To bed I go?
No, not to bed you go.
Good, I'm not tired.
Okay, so anyway, these three young men, they were godly young men. And they wanted to follow and obey God, but they were taken as prisoners all the way to Babylon. Now, King... Okay, let's try it again. King Nebuchadnezzar. He built a huge 90-foot statue, and he said that when the music played, everybody was supposed to bow down and worship this statue like it was God. Really? Yep, that's what he said. And so the music played, shkanaka, shkanaka, and everybody bowed down except for three young men, whose names were... And... They didn't do it. They did not do it. Because they knew that big old statue. Jay, they knew that that wasn't God. And they were not going to disobey. You see, they had to make a choice. And they were deciding to do what they knew was right. And so they didn't bow down. And the king, king, okay, real loud, king, he got so angry, he called them up to him. And Jay, you know what he said?
What did he say?
He looked right at him and he said,
do you want to go to McDonald's?
No, that's not what he said, Jay. He looked right at them and he said, you better bow down or I'm going to kill you.
Do what?
That's right. That's what he said.
He did not indict them to McDonald's.
No, he certainly did not. He said, one more chance. That's all you've got. And so the music played, shkanaka, shkanaka. And everybody bowed down except those three young men. Whose names were? And they still didn't bow down. They were not going to disobey God by doing what they knew was wrong. And so the king, you know what he did? King! He cranked up, Jay, he cranked up a fiery furnace 7 times hotter than it had ever been. And they took their hands and they tied their hands behind their back with rope and they marched them toward the fiery furnace. You're kidding. No, that's what they did. They marched him right to the edge, and they pushed him in.
And that's the end of the story.
No, Jay, that is not the end of the story.
It's not?
No, it is not. You see, the king, he looked into the fire, and you know what he saw?
What? Smoke?
No, he did
not see smoke. He looked in the fire, and you know what he saw? What? Flames? No, Jay. He didn't see flames. He saw four people walking around.
Thor. Hold on. Wait a minute. Thor.
That's right. He saw four people walking around.
Hold on. Shadrach? Meshach? And that other dude. That's only three.
Nope, it was Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and the Bible says the angel of the Lord was in that fiery furnace, and he protected them. You see, when they made a right choice, when they chose to follow God, when they stood up for God, God stood up for them.
Give me oil in my head, keep me burning, 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 keep me turning to the grace of
God.
Happy birthday to you.
Now, I need some people who know how to say to life. Right, Mona? You know when to say to life? They can join you loud as you can. So, you ready, Jonathan? One, two, three, four. Well, actually, 2 days ago, but I'll say today. Today is Jonathan's birthday. To Jonathan, we wish a long life.
Long life.
Oh, come on. Long life, yeah. Okay. Not only was he born back then, but he's been born again. Praise Yeshua for life. Today is Jonathan's birthday. To Jonathan, we wish a long life.
Long life.
Not only was he born back then, but he's been born again. Praise Yeshua for life. Long ago, the prophets told us that the Son would come and set his people free. La, 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 la. So Yeshua lived among us so that we could live throughout eternity. What's today? Today is Jonathan's birthday. To Jonathan, we wish a long life. He's been born again. Praise Yeshua.
Okay, we got
hey.
It. John, turn that off. Hold on one moment.
I'm holding on.
Okay, I don't know what you're holding on to, but... okay.
Yeah.
Guys, we have... Hold it. Where's the mic?
Hey.
Give me the mic.
Oh, hi.
John, give me the mic. Where's the mic?
Don't give me the mic. We have a very special guest.
Jan, can you help me get him full size?
We have a very special guest calling us all the way...
From
the Pacific Coast, California. And those of you, how many of you have ever heard of Salty the Singing Songbook? Ernie Rettino, Debbie Rettino, formerly known as Debbie Kerner. I love the first album, Debbie. Second album, Friends. Third album, More Than Friends. Yes, we know that. But this is, let me tell you this, guys, for adults and children. His stuff, this is an unpaid political announcement, is, in my opinion, some of the absolute best children's stuff out there.
Awesome.
You get the tapes, the videos, all sorts of other stuff. The songs are absolutely amazing. I judge a children's ministry thing by does it minister to me. Is there enough meat in it that ministers to me? And they really do. So I love his stuff. But this is Salty, Ernie in the flesh, and he's going to wish Jonathan. Jonathan has met him in person in California. He's chatted back and forth. I think the first time you did was his 18th birthday, which is like 16 years ago.
I saw him on James the 19th.
You did? That's right. Okay, but I'm going to put this on the mic. So, Ernie, you get to talk to Jonathan. Wish him happy birthday.
Hey, Jonathan, happy birthday. Listen, it's really nice to see you. I am so honored to be here at your birthday party. I'm glad that your dad invited me and... You and I have been speaking for the last couple of weeks anyway, but I just need to say happy birthday. And your dad asked me to sing a song. I tried to set it up so that I could get a backtrack, but that didn't happen. So, let's see. We'll try singing something here. Oh, my goodness sakes. I just finished my breakfast. I just got up. I'm old. I slept in, but I'm glad I'm here. So let's try this song. You're going to ask me to sing I Trust You, Lord, with all of my heart. I don't know it. I mean, and that was it.
Who wrote it? Who wrote it? Who wrote it? You or Debbie?
Debbie wrote that song.
That's why. Okay. Yeah. Sing whatever you like.
Yeah.
Shout out to him, blue in the face.
I have this one, Wayne, from, I think it's from Kids Phrase 8. I'm trying, I don't even know what key it's in, but here. It's called You're a Winner.
Oh.
You're
a Winner. I know that.
All right? It's a favorite song. Hey, look, it's 40 here. I have no idea how this is going to come out, but here goes. With the Lord, you're a winner. Remember this, Jonathan? Even when you lose, because the standard's not a score, but the fact you choose to do right, to serve God, and to give your all. And you win. Life is full of disappointments. It's a hard knock game. First you're up, then you're down, but there is no shame. So forge on, set your sights, and you'll reach your goal. Please, carry on. You're a winner. You're a winner. With your life when you choose, you just win, you don't lose. So stand tall.
Going in and out a little bit, but it went out for a second. Went out for a second. There, it's back. It's back. It's back. It's back. Yeah.
Because the standard's not a score, but the fact you choose to do right, to serve God, and to give your all, even when you he forgives and you win. There's the chorus. Oh. You're a winner. You're a winner. Winner.
Go ahead, John.
With your life, you just choose. You just win. You don't lose. So stand tall. Put your hands up aloud. On your high. Lift your head to the sky. On your way.
Thank you. Applause. Applause. Oh, thank you. All right, now, wait. Can Salty say hi to John for a moment? Can Salty say hi to John for a moment?
Yes, he can. If you all close your eyes.
Okay, y'all close your eyes. Salty's going to say hi to him.
Hi, Jonathan. It's me, Salty, the same songbook. Praise the Lord, I'm right here at your birthday party. Whoa, we have to thank the Zoom people for Zooming us. This is so cool. I wish I'd invented Zoom. Oh, well, I'll invent something else. But whatever, we're going to have great fun. And I have to say, Jonathan, you are one of my most faithful friends. You are one of my best friends, and I love you. And God loves you even more. I can't even believe how much he loves you. But he does. And it's one thing you've never forgotten, and you'll never forget it. Because God loves all of you, every one of you in that room. God loves you all. And he will never, ever stop loving you. He can't. Because God is love. And that's your happy birthday message, Jonathan. I love you, and Jesus loves you. Happy birthday, Jonathan.
Thank you.
Happy 34th birthday. Oh, my Columbia. All right, that's it. Salty's back.
Thank you. Thank you, Salty. And Salty, you did invent a time machine. So, you know, you've made some pretty enormous inventions.
Yeah. Oh, well, I've invented lots, but like I say, I just didn't invent Zoom.
That's right.
I mean, that one gets royalties.
That's right.
He invented the talking nose.
Well, listen, you invented the talking nose, he said. But listen, thank you so much. Give our love to Debbie, I hope she's okay. But and we'll be in touch. Thank you so much. You're looking great. Are you getting younger?
Yes.
I think so. I think so.
I am. And there are women in the room, but whatever. My secret, you know, is really just for men. But that's the way it is.
That's there. There you go. Thank you. We love you. Thank you so, so much.
Wait.
Wait. Oh, go ahead. Create. Oh, there we go.
There you go. Keep creating.
Hey, you have a red nose on you.
Oh, he just put a red nose on you. Okay. Hold it up to the camera right over there. They put it on you, John. Put it on you.
I appreciate you.
There we go. There we go.
Yeah, there you go. That's fitting.
Thank you. Oh, thank you so, so much. And I got to make sure all these people start listening to Salty. And that was no flattery. I really like your stuff. And even pre-Salty stuff especially, of course, too. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so
much. It's good to see you, Stan.
Oh, good to see you. Thank you. Bless
right.
you. And we'll talk to you soon again.
You bet. Happy birthday to everybody else in that room.
Thank
right.
you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, you bet.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You. Bye. Thank you. Oh, thank you.
All right. Now, we are going to continue to break these ventriloquist stuff, and I'm going to do some ventriloquism of my own.
And Ernie, feel free to watch if you want to watch any of it. It's a blast. But and the cake is low calorie when it's done virtually. Jan, how do we get off of speaker mode? Did you all enjoy that?
Awesome.
Wasn't that awesome?
Absolutely.
That was so sweet of him to do that. Oh, let me turn this. Okay, John. Oops. Okay, now we're going to cut the cake. Okay, we're going to cut the cake.
Who wants cake?
Nobody.
Yes, I'll eat the cake all myself. No one wants any cake. If you want cake, sign up for the cake.
It's me, Salty the Seamless.
Tech Newsweek. For the first time, I'm doing my salty, fantastic Twitch prize show right here in Miami. I jump an Eric Goldberg spoofed by 2021. Freddie, still the Lord. The Twitch boxes are going to be there. Happy the Craft, Chili Church Mouse, Whiskey Bat, a Queen, Sir, Boots, and Swiska. Freddie, still the Lord. And later at the end, I'll give you the opportunity to serve Jesus as your and Savior. I'll see you in 2021.
Okay, now we are going to do some fun trick for some very quickly, and then we are going to have a special skit for you guys.
And then the raffle.
Okay. For my intrigue prism, I have a special friend back here. Where did I put you? Aha, here he is. I keep dropping my own. Hey, Sanji, just see me, Sanji. It is so nice to meet you. Hi, Charlie. Oh, hi, Salty. What are you doing?
I'm doing good.
How are you talking?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
You don't know what you don't know?
I told you, I don't know.
Okay, why are you saying I don't know?
I don't know.
And now, let's see.
Okay?
Yeah, good thing I need you. I'm going to turn you into a puppet to you. I'm going to turn you into a puppet. Okay, so you, all you have to do is move, open close your mouth, and I'll provide the words. Okay?
Okay. Hey, ready?
Then I'll just go by the way still. Okay, you ready? Just open and close your mouth, I'll provide the words. Ready? Just open and close your mouth.
Really?
It's a nice to meet you. Don't worry, Jesus will be back.
Oh, good, thank you.
Alright, you sit there. Very good, thank you. And now, who else do I need? You, with the cheese, get up here. I'm going to turn you into a puppet. Come up here. Get up here. You're cheesing yourself out so you can get up here. I'm going to turn you into a puppet. That's what I'm going to do. For 2 years, you signed up for us. Okay, stay with the chairs. Oh, sit down in the chair. Just open and close your mouth. I'll provide the words. Yeah.
Are you enjoying yourself, Marilyn? Who else is still on?
I am, but I need to leave soon because I have to go to that other party.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yes.
You already wished him happy birthday, right?
So what are you going to do?
You already wished him. You wished him happy birthday already, right?
Okay.
I have a scripture for him.
Oh, wait, okay. Can you wait till he's just done with this? Can you wait till he's just done with this and I'll bring you out?
Okay, and now we're going to do some raffles. So if you guys have your tickets, we're going to do a raffle now. So, the first prize we are giving out is Chewbacca. Chewbacca. Okay. Who has...
Everybody look at your tickets. You can grab all the tickets on your table if you want.
If this has been tickets over there, then no one is using the... Alright, who has 07-04532? 07-04532. 532. Who has 532?
Yay!
Come up here. You get Chewbacca.
Uh-oh.
And now, for the next prize.
The next prize is a coupon book for Miami-Dade. Loaded with stuff, of course, some of the restaurants are open. They've got lots of other stuff, so
like a $25 coupon book.
Five feet free. Who has 5 feet free? Oh, you get your buzz. Typically, one of these other prizes. We have all these other.
Wait, I got a special prize for her. Hold on.
Yep, not too many of us here.
Especially if we put in the neighborhood being from the movie. What else? I know I have some other prices, but put in. Okay. We are going to raffle off some back to school prizes. Okay, the next number is.
Wait, we got something else.
Great.
Oh, yes.
Oh yeah, you have some cupcakes giveaway.
I'm just sweating all the time.
Oh, all right, next number, 516. Who has 516?
Yes!
Come on, please. Yeah. You get a special back to school notepad. Okay, who's ready for the next prize? Who has 529? 529. 529.
529. Any tickets that are left out?
Well, there's tickets over there too. Guys, there's tickets over here. Who has 529?
529.
Or one. Twice.
Over here. Hurry. Over here.
Right with the full limit of time.
Hold it. Take all of
them. Okay.
Okay, she got, but take all those.
You get special fingernails.
No,
she can't. Alright, you get that.
I was just
okay. 513. Who has 513? Aiden, come up here. Look at that, price is good. Aiden, why do you keep disappearing the prices when I just had them?
What?
Okay. Next number. Who has 508? 508. 508? Alright, you get that suffer up
the wood. Oh, wait. Okay, as soon as he finishes it. Okay, John, after that one, you gotta come here.
Who has 517?
517.
517.
Cinco, uno, siete.
Who has 517? 517?
Nobody? Next one.
Anyone have 517?
You have to pick another number. Oh, hurry, Brandon. Hurry. 517.
517. Who has 517? 517. Come up, Theo. You get a.
You got it?
Especially to watch this beautiful day, the neighborhood poster from the movie. Come up here. Get your prize.
Now, John, you got to come here because Miss Evanisco has to say goodbye. So you got to let her wish you happy birthday. Wait. She's got a scripture for you, okay?
Yes. This was great. I had a great time, Jonathan. I wish you well at 34 years old. But the word of God that God gave me. Where'd he go?
I'm up for you.
Okay. The word of God that he gave me for you is Psalm 84, verse 11. For the Lord God is a sun and a shield. The Lord gives grace and glory. No good thing does he withhold from those who walk uprightly. So that's the word for you. No good thing does he withhold from those who walk uprightly. It's Psalm 84, 11, and 12. O Lord of hosts, how blessed is the man who trusts in you. So you trust in the Lord, okay. And he's guiding you, and no good thing will he withhold from you.
Right.
In Yeshua's name. Yes. Did you get my card?
Yes, I did.
He did.
Okay. Good. Okay.
Good.
Good. Blessings to you, and we'll get together when this time comes.
Thank you. Did you enjoy the Jewish birthday song?
Huh?
Did you enjoy the Jewish birthday song?
Yes.
Did you say to life? Did you say to life?
Yes, he did. I heard
it. Okay, okay. Okay. Thank you so much. Give her a big hug.
Okay.
I love you, Jonathan.
I can only do that. So.
Big hug. Blow him a kiss. Blow him a kiss.
Bless.
Oh. There we go. Thank you so much. Thank you. Next year, hopefully, you'll be here. Bye.
Yes. Next year in Jerusalem.
Next year. Oh, amen.
Who has
the Son of by Yerushalayim. There you go.
In the real Jerusalem.
Right. There you go.
How about you?
Actually, I want to be this year.
All right. Have fun.
Bye. Thank you.
Yes. Bye-bye.
How'd you like the zero-calorie cake?
Okay, now,
yes, right up my alley. Right up my alley for the vegan girl.
Now, Pastor, I know how you like reading books, so I've got you a special three-packet book thing. So that's all for you. And now, we are going to do something I've never done in any of my life.
By the way, we have cookies and cupcakes.
We are going to give away all the prizes in this one bag. I've never done this at any of my parties before, so this is new for me. Okay. The one who's going to get all of these goodies. But wait, Vinny, did you get anything?
Yeah, I got
the cake. Okay. No, a prize. No, I said, did you get a prize?
A prize.
So, Gideon, come up here. Come up here. Come on. Don't be shy. I'm kidding. Okay. Yes, you come up here too. Now, they did not know I was planning on doing this. I had another surprise, but I didn't get it. But this is another surprise. Ain't the surprise that they know that knows a surprise, which is a surprise. Uh-huh. I know. He's confused. So anywho. So one of the songs that he apparently likes to sing, because I sing the CKI talent show, which was You Really Speak Up. And I actually saw someone when I went to Nicholas Got Talent to audition, someone actually sang the same song he did.
That's the most valuable prize.
And I think they moved to the next round or something. So, Gideon, you guys get this whole bag of goodies and a special prize as well.
All right.
So now, we are fine. Coming almost to the end. I have two quickie. To be back. I just need to go to the YouTube Superheroes room. So, how am I going to do this? Gideon, can you hold this? Because I have to put something on top of it.
Sure.
I can hold it with two hands. Mr. Rogers as a doctor here. So,
yeah.
If anything drops on your toe,
it's all right.
He'll put his sweater over your nose. Ain't that right? Hopefully you don't catch a cold.
Very good.
Oh, she's being very still. She must. Good thing she's not a jack rattle. She would probably be talking by now. That's a joke.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nice.
Hey. I'm missing some pieces. Just bear with me, okay? There's no bear. Except for I the suit. Okay.
Nice.
Now keep it like that. I need someone else to play this game.
Don't kill me, please.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
I got something to do just that. A banana. Ow. I say, don't do that. Okay. Why are you talking? I don't know. Why are you talking? I have a banana. Ow. You just put my leg.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to. This banana's going to cut you in half. Are you ready?
No.
Okay, she's ready. Good. One, two. There you go. Yourself's cutting it out. Now you can. Now you have a half of a percent of yourself. Okay. Still. Now you're back to normal. Okay, now the person who's going to play. Let's see. Dan, come over here.
Yes.
You're going to play a game.
Oh, okay.
Right. This game is called... Are you familiar with Jenga?
I am familiar with Jenga.
Oh, Jenga?
Yeah.
With a panka?
I Senga a little bit.
Hey, that's a good one. I didn't even tell him to say that. Okay, so what you do is you take one of these pieces, put on top, and there's different challenges.
Mm-hmm.
One of them is... You put it on top, and you have to make her laugh.
What?
Yep. That's the instructions. I don't make this stuff up. And then you give it to him, and he puts a piece on top, and then you have to spin around, and then give it to her, and then when you put the piece on top, you have to do it behind your back.
How am I supposed to put the piece on top without dropping it?
You can figure it out, maybe you have a twin or something. And the other one is, you can kick a... Oh, the good thing I have is, you can kick a ball. Oh, yes. Don't worry, it won't go boom like that. It will just be on the ground. It will just be on the ground, okay? Like, it will be like that. And then it will try to be on balance. Then the hardest one of all.
Okay.
Is blindfolded.
Oh.
It won't be you, it will be him. Oh, he has a blindfold. Hey, this is good. That way you'll be blindfolded. Okay, I have this ball here.
The
mask.
The mask Jenga.
Okay, are you guys ready?
Yes.
All right. You're going to start first. You're going to start regular, then go crazy. Okay. You go first.
He can
you
do
just
it.
Just take one piece and put it on top.
If it's not
you, you can put it on. Okay. Yeah, put it on top. All right. Now give it to
nice.
Him.
What?
Give it to him.
I have to take the whole thing.
Yeah.
Oh.
And now you have to do it blindfolded to put the thing on. All right, now take it from anywhere and put it on top.
Oh, no.
Now, I've never played this game before, so this is my first time doing this game. All right, put it on top.
That is
now,
awesome.
Give it to her.
That is awesome.
And now, we're going to make it tricky for you, Kaden. I'm going to have this ball like that. So, do you? So, do it. Go, do it.
Oh.
Good, good. Then you get your Oh, so you owe me $1 million bucks.
Good job.
All right, now for the hardest part for you. She has to make you laugh when you are trying to put it on.
Oh.
No,
I'm
so bad. Oh, sorry. It's the rules. You have to do it.
Okay.
Just make a silly face or laugh. It doesn't matter. Put the piece on. That's usually like
it. He laughed a little bit.
That was a
trouble. I mean, that's he's laughing already. See, this is good. Now for the hardest part of them all.
Okay.
Now actually, now you put the piece on and you have to give it to him behind your back.
Oh.
I told you this is part of the rules. I don't make this stuff up here.
All right.
How am I supposed to do this?
I do this and then give it to him. I turn around and give it to him. Right? I give it to him.
Nice.
See, that was so bad, that was it. Right. Now, for you, it's the hardest part of all. After you put it on, you have to put it under your leg and give it to her.
I see.
Don't worry, you don't have to do it the under leg, only he does it. Alright, so do it under your leg and give it to her. Oh, you win! Katie, I have a special prize for you. You get a bread of God.
Yeah.
There you go.
Alright, sit down. And before we go, I'm going to do something I haven't done since 99.
Wow.
I am going to juggle. Like I said, I'm going to juggle some balls, and then I'm going to do something I never juggled in my life. Katie, you're going to come back up here. I'm not going to juggle you, don't worry. You're going to be here in the middle. Doesn't matter, sit down, whatever. And Francisco, come up here. We're going to juggle these balls over her head.
Ah.
And I did not rehearse this.
I didn't.
So, Katie, if this falls on your head at any time, we have Mr. Rogers right there.
Oh, man.
To put his foot on your nose.
Oh,
alright, so go over there, Francisco.
Did you want them to use the bowling balls?
What?
Did you want them to use the bowling balls?
Do we have bowling balls here?
No, we don't.
Oh, maybe next year I'll use a bowling ball next time. Oh, she's swallowing over. She can't. Don't worry, we're not doing bowling balls. We don't have those. But next time I will. Alright, you ready for this school?
Mm-hmm.
She's ready. Oh, I'm going to play some special music here. You ready, Francisco? You ready, Katie? Good, she's ready. Because we're going to do two balls next. Are you ready? Here we go. One, two, hey, Katie, it's a bee. She's not falling for it. Okay, she said it's a bee. Alright, you ready? One, two. I moved too fast, she didn't even see it. Alright, you ready? Alright, now falling to me. Oh, my achy, freaky heart. Now the hard part, two balls. You ready? Alright. Ooh, caught it. Ooh. Oh, I dropped it on her head. See? I dropped it. Now we're going to use the hardest bit. We're going to throw a
nose.
And a ball. And a cup. We're going to do one at a time. All right, Francisco, stay there. Now, I'm going to poke my nose.
Oh.
Now, the cup.
Okay.
All right. Now, all three, I can afford to you, and you just use it as your hands, okay? So you set me ready for this now.
You can do it.
Uh-oh. Are you ready, Francisco?
Drum roll.
Are you ready? All right, here we go. It's called the Flip Bottle Challenge. So, what I'm going to do, I've not done this since 2014, I'm going to flip this bottle on here. Now, if it lands on my foot.
Okay, we're done. We have to stop right now.
We have to do this.
We have to stop right now. No, I'm kidding.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Now, if this falls on my foot, Katie, it's your fault. Katie, I'm blaming this on you if this falls on my foot. You have to pay me $1 million if it falls. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Alright, are you ready? 1, 2. Hey, Katie, you have a beast behind you. Nope, that's not okay. Woo! It worked! I know, someone wants me to end this. I know we're going to end this. Dad, can you get a trash bag so we can put the stuff in?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, Francisco,
where are they?
They are in the table closet. So while we are waiting for him, we're going to do the most giant card trick of them all. Who has put a free card Monty?
Me.
I have.
Oh, this is called 8 Kogmonti. Okay. So you guys keep your eye on the 8 of diamonds, okay? Alright, I'm going to do a sneaky move. Here it is. And you mean actually tell these parts of. Alright. Sneaky move. Number 2. Faithful good measure. 4. So you won't get bored. 5. Eat pumpkin pie. 6. Connect sticks. 7. 7 is great for 7 and 11. And 8. You eat cake. Okay. So I'm alright. Alright. Who thinks it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8? Who knows who the 8 of diamonds is? Kaden, do you know who it is? You think it's this video card? It's a 9. Why would 7 and 9? Because 9, 8, 7. Okay. We're down to 7 cards. Who thinks it's this card? You think it's this card?
No.
Who thinks it's this card right here?
Okay,
Okay. Who thinks it's this card right here? Brandon, yeah, put the stuff in here. Well, guess what? You're wrong again.
I'll put it here.
We're down to the last 5 card. Who thinks it's this first card that's doing the same you in the eye? Who thinks it's this first card?
Yeah.
Well, guess what? He's in. He's good.
People, you have to be good.